YouTube, this is the Sarcasm Detector coming to you from first base on the Acrimony Dragon server in Ark Survival Evolved. This is episode 2 of season 2, and if you remember from the last episode, I had shown you around the base briefly and taken out Buzzy the Battle Beaver for a little bit of a romp in the local area. For this episode, we're going to take a look at dinosaur mating, as well as show you around the base a little bit. Let's take a look here. So I built a little bit of a pen for the pterodons, and they're already in there. And to get them to mate is quite simple. All I have to do... is walk up to them, and hopefully I'll get the option. Just enable wandering. You see the little hearts popping up over their name? The area might actually be a little too big for them. So they're going at it, and if I look at the female here, Stripes, you can see her mating progress. Once that reaches full, we should see a fertilized egg come out. I might just fast forward this a little bit till the egg comes out. So now we have the egg. Let's rush over here real quick. And we're just going to drop it right here in front of the air conditioners so that it's insulated. You can see the egg health is at max. That's the red bar. So that's good. Didn't take any damage. And the egg incubation timer is ticking down. So hopefully this won't take too much time. See here the stats. It'll show you the two parents, the name of the two parents that came out. So we're gonna wait for that. That shouldn't take too long. In the meantime, let's have a look at the base upstairs. Oh, hey, Buzzy, how are you doing? So, the first area here, before we see what's up there, is the barracks. Lots of bunk beds for fast respawning. This is the locker room, the treasure room, the vault room. And so, yeah, different things, primitive weapons, tools, armor, ranged weapons, a whole lot of different stuff in here. I gotta learn to close the door behind me. And here is the kitchen. So we got the industrial grill. Throw in some raw meat, turn it on, and they will turn into cooked meat. Thank you. preservation bin. This throw in some cooked meat with some oil and spark powder. It'll turn it into jerky, which I should move to the jerky fridge. Our industrial cooker. So this works like the cooking pot. It's already connected to water. Gunpowder, charcoal, needs gasoline to run, and you put different recipes. Very handy for making lots of dyes at the same time. Little water tap. Of course, all our fridges, which are, of course, named. We have a elevator here that will take us to the roof. But before we head to the roof, let's take a look at the second floor. So this is the trophy room, and we already have one artifact. It's making room for more. And this is our fabrication area. So we got a Master Forge, silent electric fabricator, some lockers to hold certain materials, the smithy, and a crafting table. Let's check on the progress of the egg real quick before we head to the roof. So we do have quite a bit of time. Some of the doors will close automatically, others are still the old style. It's called the elevator. This floor I'm not quite sure what to do with yet. But this is the roof here. You can see I've got four of the dragons resting up here. It's a perfect parking spot for them. And somebody's bird is here as well. It's a good spot for the flyers up here. And fairly quick access from the residence, which is this little glass house here. Probably turn that off. Hey Buzzy, you doing okay? He's got berries and wood. He's not gonna go hungry up here. So, it's getting close. It shouldn't take too much longer, maybe another 10 or so minutes. We do have meat in both the fridges down here. There should be meat here. That one just has a few berries. Another water tap in case people get hungry. This is actually a very hot area of the map. So a lot of water is required. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to fast forward this quite a bit to the point where the egg is just about to hatch. That's some battle music. I wonder what's going on. I don't see any fighting out here. Oh. Stupid Dilo. Come on, Fancy. People really gotta put their dinos back in their pens after they're done with them. And I'll do that later. Oh, by the way, spoilers! We'll get to these two shortly. Very close, so we'll just speed it up again and catch you after the jump. Alright, so egg is almost hatched. Let's grab some meat. Last few seconds. Kinda excited to see what we get. There's always the possibility of getting twins or even triplets sometimes. Oh. Hello there, little guy. Let's do an imprint. And they're born starving. But can hardly carry any meat, so basically what I have to do is sit here and as you can see, as he's growing, his weight is increasing. So we got some good stats on this guy. The maturation process, it's right at the start. He's already eaten some of the meat. Fortunately, as babies, they cannot feed themselves. Or I should say, they cannot eat from the feeding trough. So we have to make sure they have enough meat in their inventory. Which involves quite a bit of babysitting, unfortunately. The thing I've done is the naming convention. So the dragons that I've been breeding are named after Japanese numbers. So their first name is a Japanese number. So Sa, for example, is number 4. G is the generation, and their last name is the name of their parents. Just helps me keep track. So for this guy, for the pterodons, I've decided to use Arabic numbers. Might go with French numbers for the T-Rexes, or different languages. So this is actually going to take quite a little bit of time. He won't be able to eat from the feeding trough by himself until he becomes a juvenile, which is at about 10% maturation process. So yeah, it's going to take a little bit of time. Fortunately, on this server, the everything to do with breeding has been ramped up. Not a lot, by about 5 times. So For example, the egg part usually takes an hour or so. It took us roughly 10 minutes. A little bit longer than 10 minutes. Of course, some of the dinos are faster than others. The smaller dinos are fairly fast. So I would really hate to do this with a quetzal, which are huge, or T-Rexes. Probably won't be recording that because that's going to be pretty much most of the day spent just babysitting the dinos. I might actually do record it and just chop it up into little bits just for easier consumption. He's so cute. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Come back. I think it's time for more fast forwarding, so I'll be back with you guys when this guy hits juvenile. Alright, so he just turned into a juvenile, and we can actually leave him alone now. He should be fine. If you see over his name, there's that little, it's hard to see, but there's a little feeding trough icon over his name. That means he is eating from the feeding trough. We don't have to keep putting food into him. So that actually took a little bit longer than I expected. That was more like 35 minutes, 40 minutes to get from baby to juvenile. So what I might do instead of running fast forward through it, a little bit of lag there, sorry about that, is I might just chop it off and have it play in the corner of the screen at a extreme fast forward. Or not, we'll see. These guys, we still have them on wander, so let's stop it. Actually, Stripes, you're, come here. You've done good today, so let's park you back on top here. It's calling the elevator back up. Head back down. I think it's time for something a little bit more spectacular. What do you think? So that was the pterodon. It's a first pterodon baby. So hopefully we'll get much more. But now let's give our dragons a look here. So we have two of them. Here's Stud Muffin, and he is pretty much our first male dragon. We had so many females, but finally we got a nice high level male. Absolutely fantastic. He is actually the parent, the father of all the generation one dragons that we've bred, and the grandfather of all the generation twos. There's not a lot of them. And this is Ruby, our latest tame. Absolutely fantastic stats. That's just incredible what this lady can do. So I'm hoping we'll get some really good dragon babies from this pair. Let's close that door. She got meat on her, she does. So I'm just going to transfer this meat over to the fridges, since we used a bit of it on the pterodon. As much as I can grab. I think that should be enough. If I need more, I can just run up to her. This fridge filled up again. Might as well fill this one up as well. The jerky's mine, actually. So this guy should be alright. It might take most of the day for him to reach adulthood. Probably by sometime tomorrow morning, he'll be capable of flying, of being ridden like his parents. Hey, Spot, you doing all right there? So, it's basically the same thing. We don't actually need a pen for these guys. And here we go. Just watching them do their thing. What you see on Stud's head there is a actual dragon helmet. Just gotta make one for Ruby. SFW sign on this video. They're not shy at all. Yes, it's a pretty big egg. All right. This one hopefully is going to be a little bit faster. Let's make these guys a little bit out of the way. Yeah, it's going at a good pace, so... And let's move this back to this regular resting spot. So this is the barn I was showing you in the last episode. It's actually been mostly completed. Let's do a flyby of the base. There's still some walls that need to go up. I think those platforms are still incomplete. Yeah, it's a big barn. I missed it. Yeah, that needs to be a bit bigger. Nope, that didn't work. All right. The elevator actually works. Got it all the way up to the roof. Did it actually get here or not? Might have sent it down to the ground floor. Oops. Yeah, I sent it to the ground floor. It's a Bronto walking over Armstrong's pub there. That's why. This guy's in the wrong spot. I realize I left the door open. So you see all those dragons we have. Hopefully we're going to have quite a few more after this process. Okay, nothing nasty snuck in to eat our baby or egg. And where are we at? Okay, not too bad. So I'm going to actually skip ahead just to the point where the egg's hatching. And we'll catch you right after the jump. Alright, we're back and we're at the last few minutes. So time to get a little bit of meat. I am really excited. I wonder what we're gonna get. Male or female? Preferably I would actually prefer some females. The males can mate at any time. The females actually have a cooldown. From what I've seen, it's between 5 and 10 days between when they can lay fertilized eggs. So having more females means more dragons born. Also, it would be nice to get twins or triplets. Oh, here we go, we're almost there. Also curious what kind of color we're gonna get. Small baby dragon. Think of the name in a second. And this one, they grow up a little bit faster than pretty much everything else, so that's a good thing, but they still take quite a bit of time to get to full grown. We got a male. Coloring's a little bit half and half. So we got the blue parts from his dad. And the red neck and the white belly, spine, and wings of his mom. Look at his stats. Oh, that is actually pretty impressive. And he popped out at level 191. Absolutely fantastic. It's one of the better dragons yet. This is it's actually almost as good as some of the second gen ones. Actually, might be even better than some of the second gen ones that we have. He's growing fairly fast. So I don't think we have to worry too much about him starving to death. Yeah, he's definitely growing a lot faster than the Turn it on. So I think that's it for this episode. I think in the next episode, we'll wait till this guy is fully matured, and we'll take him out and level him up a little bit. See what he can do. Yeah, sounds like a good idea. I thank you for watching this episode, and stay tuned for more to come. This has been Sarcasm Detector. If you like this video, give it a like, subscribe, and tell all your friends.